Greetings! Welcome back to another video for Kerbal Space Program. Okay, this video should be quite amusing. We have somewhere. Where did I save it? The rover. Completely new design this one is. Oh, that's the rover with the... Ah, there it is. That one. I'll just load the correct one. Completely new design on this one. Been playing around with rocket cars in another sandbox. And ended up making a rover of sorts, and I'm like, that's a nice design. So I built this. Okay, it's not a rover, it's a tank. Right, in the middle that you cannot actually see is a Mark 1 lander can in there. Now, yes, these are advanced large reaction wheels, and on top of the lander can, which I think I actually showed you, is advanced SAS. What is the point of that, hey, you ask? Well, while driving, you don't always have your finger on the accelerator, especially going downhill. So if you turn the advanced SAS on, it uses the reaction control wheels to keep you stable. So if you hit a rock or something, or funky terrain that tries to flip you over, the advanced SAS kicks in, stops you, and slams you back down again. So it helps to prevent you from tipping over. We have 5 parachutes on here, which I'm not quite sure they work. And a ruckload of solar panels. Oh, and 2 big batteries. So yeah, it's not exactly a lightweight thing. RCS on here. Yep, definitely need RCS. And 6, 8, 10, 12, 14 wheels. Need 14 wheels because I keep popping them. Well, at least I do on Kerbal. Plenty of lights on the front, which that one actually isn't centre, but never mind. And now we have fuel tanks here, which are fed by these 3, front and rear. I didn't put any transfer in between front and rear, I didn't think it was necessary. And so far I haven't ran out at the front or the back before the other. So, how does it drive? Shall we take a look? And it would be daylight. It would be dark time. Oh, lights seem to work. Frame rate is about 14 frames a second. Now I did reorientate the lander can, so at least it will drive in the correct direction, he says. Oh, and I've blown a tire already. That's just typical. Yes. Man flagpole. Whatever the hell that is. So it does actually seem to do. Oops, mental note. Don't try and multitask out while doing a video. Well, it was an accident. But still. Nice and slowly this time, so we don't burst it out. Oh, too late. Come on, turn. Okay, what the... Let's start this again. Okay, I'm back. That would be a PC crash, which is getting annoying. All day yesterday, I was in KSP, building my station, did a video, no crash. Today, I've crashed about 3 times. I've only been using my PC for 4 hours. Seriously? Anyway, let's do this test again, shall we? Throttle up. SAS on. Go. So we're running at 10 frames per second. Meters. As I was saying, when I tested this, it got up to 20,000, including the coast, which is pretty good actually. Clear of the lower atmosphere, and now we're draining the fuel on the outer tanks and of course accelerating. ...700 meters per second... ...800 meters per second... 900 meters per second. 1 kilometer per second. And hey presto. I think I made improvements to this because we're going to leave the atmosphere. In fact, I could probably get into orbit. Ah, not far off. 107.9, so 108 kilometers it's saying. Slowing down. Excuse me. And down we come. Should take us out of time warp at about 60 something kilometres. There we go. Let's turn the lights on. Not going to be able to see much. And it looks like we're going to come down over water. Oh? Ireland? Or is that cloud? Island. Well, let's go and test the parachutes. They are deployed. Well, activated for deployment, I should say. On this one, we've got Anna Kerman. I think we got a little bit warm there. That's okay, parachutes are out. Can't see anything underneath us. Oh, there we go, we're starting to see the water texture now. Oh, sort of. I did do. Oh, it's all black again. Well, we'll know when we'll hit the water. Well, at least I assume it's water. Oh, crap. Oh, dear. I admittedly did not test the parachutes. Mental note, more parachutes. Oh, well. Structural failure between RCS fuel tanks. It pulled the fuel tank off. Yep, then it pulled the batteries off. Fuel tanks. Rover max and structural panel. Yep. Ooh, bugger. So let's go revert to vehicle assembly. So let's take a look at the station. What, no launching the rover? Nope. Although I will show you that. What the? Rover ready to launch. I thought I deleted that. Oh, I'll go recover it. Anyway, let's have a look at the station. And there we are. Not much has changed, but as you can see, we've got the solar panels up. Not all of them are deployed at the moment. Got three lighting modules up, and we've got our rover docked. I am surprised that I managed to dock that without destroying something. And yes, I know that the size of the rover dwarfs the entire vessel, but still. So, what's left to do? Well, these modules here need to be collected up and added to the other long line. Lighting modules need to be distributed, and then we're going to be ready to launch, going back to the moon. Now hopefully the rover will behave itself. Now obviously we can't use the parachutes on the moon because there is no atmosphere, which is probably a good thing anyway. But we've got more rocket power and more fuel, so we should be able to put it down. Oh, another thing that I've got to do, fuel the darn thing. That's going to take a while. It has been manoeuvred around a bit, and there's no shaking, shimmying and general fun apart from these Kerbals, which are starting to look a bit green. So, best place for the rover I decided was right on the front of one of the fuel tanks, because if I slung it underneath, it'd be liable to twist and bend around, especially with that much SAS on it, which I'm probably going to have to disable the SAS, otherwise it may cause an issue or two, or break itself off completely and go its own way. But I'm looking forward to it. So once I get rid of the excess modules, which I think I'm just going to leave in orbit, I'll probably just push them behind and let them float away. The frame rate's a little bit on the low side at the moment, but that being said, once I get rid of those the excess, it should speed it up a bit. Touch wood. Oh, the worker bee got replaced. If you don't know if you noticed, but on the original worker bee, the docking port here was off center. So when I sent up the replacement solar panels and the lighting module, I sent up another worker bee, and that was corrected and right and whatnot. So also my suggestion last time for the worker bees of extending the length of them, so that the RCS had there was a greater distance between the RCS quads, that worked much better. So there's a good tip for you. So as you can see on there, previously I had two tanks, I think it was, but this has got four on it. I think it was either one or two tanks of these. This one's got four, and it works so much better. It really does. As you can see, there's just eight quads, four at the front, four at the back, and job done. And of course it's got its own set of solar panels, which actually indicates which way is up on the vessel, which makes life a little bit easier, but also it keeps the battery charged. Plenty of lights on there. We've got four forward, four back, and I've got four that are just out to the sides. So I'm not quite sure if they actually do anything being like that, because they kind of recess into that RCS fuel tank. Not sure. Anyway, we've got our A-team up here. Need to fetch up some RCS as well. Yeah, we've got our A-team up here, as well as Sindrian Kerman, who's in the rover. He's loving it. Not at all green like Bob. There we go. I will get the rest done, and the next video we will be plotting to move to the moon. Have fun, and MCW, crash hard.